You're watching a genomics education module produced by the Division of Genomic Medicine at UC Davis. This module will focus on different tests used in molecular genetics, how they're different, and when to use each one. Let's start by talking about the broad categories of molecular diagnostic test types. If you suspect that an individual might be affected by a chromosomal abnormality, you'll need to do a cytogenetic analysis. Chromosomal abnormalities include issues like an extra or missing chromosome, as in trisomy 21, or extra or missing parts of chromosomes. There are a few different options for cytogenetic analysis, which will be discussed in a different module called cytogenetics. If you want to zoom in on a chromosome and take a closer look at the sequence of DNA bases, you will need to do a molecular genetic analysis. However, in the quickly changing field of genetics and genomics, cytogenetics and molecular genetics continue to overlap more and more. Let's say that you've decided that you want to run a molecular genetics analysis. Now you'll need to consider which test to use. There are a variety of options. To determine which is the best test for your particular case, you'll need to think about which part or parts of the genome and how much of the genome you need to assess. For example, if you want to look at all nucleotides in the entire genome, you can order whole genome sequencing. For a human, this means sequencing all 3 billion base pairs in the human genome. The whole genome includes coding regions like exons, as well as non-coding regions such as introns and regulatory elements. Here are a few common clinical indications for whole exome sequencing: diagnostic odyssey, many differential diagnoses, atypical disease presentation, or disorder with a high degree of genetic heterogeneity. Another option is whole exome sequencing, or sequencing of just the exome. Whole exome sequencing captures just the parts of DNA that code for the mature RNA strand. Common clinical indications for whole exome sequencing are similar to those for whole genome sequencing. It is important to keep in mind, however, that whole exome sequencing does not provide any detailed information beyond just the protein coding regions of each gene. To get that information, whole genome sequencing is required. Another option is targeted mutation analysis. This is useful when you already have a suspected condition or group of conditions in mind and know where the associated gene is located. For example, if you are testing a patient for sickle cell anemia, there is no need to sequence more than one specific locus. Targeted mutation analysis is usually used for individuals who have an affected family member with a disorder who has already had genetic testing and a specific mutation in a gene was identified. These individuals would then be tested for the same mutation in the same targeted gene. In some cases, you may have a hypothesis for a condition or group of conditions you'd like to test for. If that condition has locus heterogeneity, meaning that it can be caused by multiple genes, you may want to consider ordering a panel test. For example, many genes can contribute to breast cancer, so a breast cancer panel may sequence a dozen or more specific genes that are known to be associated with breast cancer. Panel testing is usually done when a patient has a specific condition that can be caused by a number of different genes, such as breast cancer or hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. So to recap, there are many different options for molecular genetic testing. The most important question to answer before deciding on which of these options to go with is how much of the genome you need to analyze. The sequencing method of choice today is next-generation sequencing, or NGS. NGS utilizes massively parallel, high-throughput technology to produce large-scale automated genome analyses. This is much faster and cheaper than the original method, Sanger sequencing. So to recap, there are 4 main test types available for DNA analysis at the level of the nucleotide: whole genome sequencing, whole exome sequencing, targeted mutation analysis, and panel testing. If you would ever like help deciding which is the most appropriate genetic test to order for your patient, the Division of Genomic Medicine is here to help. Our clinic is located in the Mind Institute on the medical campus in Sacramento. You can refer patients to our genomic medicine clinic, visit our website, or call us with questions or to speak with a genetic counselor.